Hi and welcome to the session. I am Purva and I will help you with the following question. Evaluate the definite integral, limit from 0 to pi by 2, cos square x upon cos square x plus 4 sin square x dx. Let us now begin with the solution. Let us denote this definite integral by I. So we have I is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi by 2, cos square x upon cos square x plus 4 sin square x dx. This is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 cos square x upon cos square x plus 4. Now we can write sin square x as 1 minus cos square x dx. This is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 cos square x upon cos square x plus, now opening the bracket we get 4 minus 4 cos square x dx, and this is further equal to integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 cos square x upon 4 minus 3 cos square x dx, because cos square x minus 4 cos square x gives us minus 3 cos square x. This is equal to, now multiplying the numerator and denominator by minus 3, we get minus 1 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 minus 3 cos square x upon 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. This is equal to minus 1 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2. Now adding and subtracting 4 in numerator, we get 4 minus 3 cos square x minus 4 upon 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. And we can write this as, this is equal to minus 1 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 4 minus 3 cos square x upon 4 minus 3 cos square x minus 4 upon 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. This is equal to minus 1 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2. Now cancelling numerator and denominator, here we get 1 minus 4 upon 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. And we can write this as, this is equal to minus 1 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 dx. Minus into minus will become plus, so plus 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 dx upon 4 minus 3 cos square x. This is equal to minus 1 upon 3. Now integrating 1 we get x, and limit is from 0 to pi by 2 plus 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 dx upon 4 minus 3 cos square x. And this is equal to minus 1 upon 3. Now putting the limits, we get pi by 2 minus 0, because the upper limit is pi by 2. So putting pi by 2 in place of x, we get pi by 2, and lower limit is 0. So putting 0 in place of x, we get 0 plus 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 dx upon 4 minus 3 cos square x. And this is equal to minus pi by 6, because pi by 2 minus 0 is equal to pi by 2, and pi by 2 into minus 1 upon 3 will give us minus pi by 6, plus 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 dx upon 4 minus 3 cos square x. This is equal to minus pi upon 6 plus 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2. Now we divide the numerator and denominator by cos square x. So we get 1 upon cos square x upon 4 upon cos square x minus 3 cos square x upon cos square x dx. And this is equal to minus pi by 6 plus 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2. Now 1 upon cos square x is equal to sec square x. So we get sec square x upon 4 sec square x minus 3 dx. And this is equal to minus pi by 6 plus 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 sec square x upon 4 into, now we can write sec square x as 1 plus tan square x. So 1 plus tan square x minus 3 dx. This is equal to minus pi by 6 plus 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 sec square x upon, now opening the bracket we get 4 plus 4 tan square x minus 3 dx. And this is equal to minus pi by 6 plus 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 sec square x upon, now 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So 1 plus 4 tan square x dx. This is equal to minus pi upon 6 plus, now we denote 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 sec square x upon 1 plus 4 tan square x dx by I1. So we write plus I1. Now we consider I1. So we have I1 is equal to 4 upon 3 integral limit from 0 to pi by 2 sec square x upon 1 plus 4 tan square x dx. Now we put tan x equal to t. So put tan x equal to t. Differentiating, we get sec square x dx is equal to dt. Now, when x is equal to lower limit, that is, when x is equal to 0, we have t is equal to 0. Because putting here 0 in place of x, we get tan 0, which is equal to 0. So we get t is equal to 0. And when x is equal to upper limit, that is, when x is equal to pi by 2, we have t is equal to tan pi by 2, and tan pi by 2 is equal to infinity. So we get t is equal to infinity. Putting all these values in I1, we get I1 is equal to 4 by 3 integral limit from 0 to infinity dt upon 1 plus 4 t square. This is equal to, now multiplying and dividing the denominator by 4, we get 4 upon 3 into 1 upon 4 integral limit from 0 to infinity dt upon 1 by 4 plus t square. Cancelling 4 in numerator and denominator here, we get this is equal to 1 by 3 integral limit from 0 to infinity dt upon, now we can write 1 upon 4 as 1 upon 2 whole square plus t square. Now, since we know that integral dx upon a square plus x square is equal to 1 upon a tan inverse x by a. Therefore, we can write this as this is equal to 1 upon 3 into 1 upon 1 by 2 tan inverse t upon 1 by 2 and limit is from 0 to infinity. So, we apply this formula dx upon a square plus x square integral and this is equal to 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a. So, in this taking a is equal to 1 upon 2 and x is equal to t, we get 1 upon 1 by 2 tan inverse t upon 1 by 2. And this is equal to 2 upon 3 tan inverse 2t and limit is from 0 to infinity. This is equal to 2 upon 3. Now putting the limits we get tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse 0. Because we have the upper limit as infinity, so putting infinity in place of t we get tan inverse infinity minus lower limit is 0, so putting 0 in place of t we get tan inverse 0. And this is equal to 2 by 3 into, now we know that tan of pi by 2 is equal to infinity, so we get tan inverse infinity is equal to pi by 2 minus, and we know that tan of 0 is 0, so we get tan inverse 0 is equal to 0. And this is equal to pi by 3. So we get I1 is equal to pi by 3. Therefore we have I is equal to minus pi by 6 plus pi by 3. And this is equal to pi by 6. So we get I is equal to pi by 6. Thus we get our answer as pi by 6. Hope you have understood the solution. Bye and take care.